I got a new. Have you seen the new kerosene model? You don't need plugs or anything. Just fill it up. Can we have that new exploding D? Yeah, no rehearsal.
Let me have a quick smoky first.
Let me have a hit off your wheel there, partner. Just hit off your ready roll. Tailor made, store bought.
My kids can't see me smoking. They might be in Canada, you never can tell.
My mama doesn't know I smoke yet. Of course, my in-laws don't think I'm sleeping with their daughter either.
You're not, are you? Oh, excuse me.
You mean Kristen and Josh are yours and Jonathan?
Oh, no.
Wherever you are, Mr. Serling, I believe that I'm a sterling example of the Twilight Zone you used to rave about. I've been a picking and a grinning 30 days without a day off. I've given, well, I'm afraid I'm plumb give out. I'm getting weirder by the minute from the things I ain't been smoking, and reality is blowing me away. I've been searching for me everywhere from Vegas to Hoboken, and if you see me, kindly tell me I went that away. You see, all my bread ain't hardly done, and if it were, I'd still be one brick shy of the number it takes to make up a load. My hair just died of jet lag, and I'm zipped inside my hanging bag, so check this bag, Nashville Porter. God, I love the road. They're all in the dictionary. I put every one of them in there I knew.
Got too much highs on it for you? Is it? I was going to tell everybody about
that. Hey, listen. It's I have not seen you in a while, and I figured it's time for me to go back to school. Why don't you teach me something? Learn me something, son.
Nothing's happening every minute, man.
Nothing's happening every minute. I didn't come here, and I ain't leaving. Right? Just play me a song, why don't you?
All right.
Teacher, Professor Newbury.
Georgia. Oh, I wish I was an old guitar. sorry.
Wish there was an old guitar sitting in a worn-out car.
Oh, I can't remember.
I remember the song.
I'll just forget all the intro now. I can't go through that.
We'll start over at letter A. Wish I was a
willow. I wish I was a willow tree, leaning on a lazy breeze, moving like a midnight train through rainy Georgia. I wish it was a grain of sand, laying in a baby's hand, falling like a diamond chain into the ocean. Cause a willow tree is strong enough to bend. Never like the oak that lives in fear of the wind. Oh, a grain of sand is all I ever wanted to be. Wash over me, wash over me. Oh, I wish I was an old guitar, sitting in a beat up car, heading never too big far from here to Texas. You know, I wouldn't be ashamed to look up my old friends. They would be so glad to see me strung up again.
Up and stuff. We have a good friend. I wrote a song for him. I can't mention his name. I was in a bar one night in Atlanta. And these people were, I don't know whether they were drunk, but they'd been critically overserved, if you know what I mean. And he was sitting there playing these magic songs on his guitar, and nobody was paying any attention to him. It kind of, I want y'all to drag out the standing here trying to matter. Just catch up to him wherever you can, man. I'm standing here trying to matter, and I don't think I'm making the grade. Cause whoever's in charge of the dues I've been paying forgot to mark down that I'd pay. It's all over now, but the shouting, cause they're no longer shouting for there's someone no one's dying to see. And it's all over now, but the shout, 'cause there's nobody shouting for me. So I'm just standing here crying and trying to matter, just an old fool. No one's dying to see.
That's fine.
Son,
I forgot how good this song was.
Huh? You forgot who it's about?
I forgot how good it was.
Oh, thank you. Well, when I see things like that, you know, all you can do is write about it. I mean, we can gripe and complain, but that doesn't do any good anyway. So. That's a good job, man. Y'all will take us up full time. Well?
Don't look at me, man.
Do something else, Newbury.
What you want to hear?
I want to hear Frisco Maplejoy. Of course, you know I think it's the best song I ever heard in my life. I try to write it every time I sit down and write a song. That's what I'm trying to do.
Doing that imitation.
Well, his daddy was an honest man.
Well, I
take the clothespin
off
your nose, Newbury,
like that no more.
Sing it.
Ooh, hold it. That's got a hold of one of them shorts and curlies.
Oh. Was an honest man.
Jesse Red Dare, Georgia. Can I have some more coffee while we're at that? I take it intravenously, but black if there's no...
Man, I did.
When his daddy was a man, used to rent there in Georgia farmer. Mama in the short line and kids been hanging.
San Francisco Maple Joy.
Good luck on trying to find this one. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Yeah.
We got to step on some separate tracks on which it works. You're going to be able to fix it.
Ragtag little girl.
Is it sliding again?
Big blue eyes. Yeah.
Best stand to feed my kind.
Okay. And what's great, you can go back and play over it if you needed to. That sounds loose like it. I like it.
Fade it out quicker. So what are we going to pick up?
Yeah, let's pick up from...
What was the intro to Frisco Maplejoy?
What key are you doing? A? Something like... Yep.
Yeah, it's half step up. No, it may be a full step up.
It's a whole step. Well, it's daddy.
When daddy.
Sing my favorite song, Turkey.
Well, his daddy was an honest man, red dirt Georgia farmer. His mama lived a short life, having kids, bailing hay. He had 15 years and an ache inside to wander. Jumped freight and way cross, wound up in L.A. Oh, the cold nights had no pity on that Waycross, Georgia farm boy. Most days he went hungry, then the summer came, and he met a girl known on the strip as San Francisco's Mabel Joy. Destitution's child, born on an L.A. street called shame. Growing up came quietly in the arms of Mabel Joy. Laughter found his mornings, brought a meaning to his life. On the night before she left, sleep came and left that Waycross country boy with dreams of Georgia cotton and a California wife. Sunday morning found him standing 'neath the red light at her door. Went right across, sent him reeling, put him face down on the floor. Yes, in place of his Mabel Joy, he found a merchant mad marine who growled, "Your Georgia neck is red, but sunny, you're still green." He turned 21 in a gray rock federal prison. Old judge had no mercy on that Waycross, Georgia boy. Staring at those four gray walls, in silence he would listen to that midnight freight he knew could take him back to Mabel Joy. Sunday morning found him lying 'neath the red light at her door, with a bullet in his side. He cried, "Have you seen me?" Stunned and shaken, someone said, "Son, she don't live here no more. No, she left this house 4 years today. They say she's looking for some Georgia farm boy."
Out of tune.
Yeah, but this right in step. Somebody asked me, I was doing an interview.
Sunday morning.
Doing an interview for a magazine about 2 months ago. They asked me to list my favorite 10 songs of all time. And I put that song first. I think that's the best song I've ever heard, front to back.
I didn't teach you anything, did I?
Yes, you did. You did. And they asked me right behind that what were the 10 favorites that I'd written. And this one was number one on my list. If they, you know, if I were going to die tomorrow, which I might, but and they asked me, what song would you want, if you could sing one song that showed what you think is your craft or your artisanship or your craftsmanship, what would it be? And it'd be this one that I wrote, trying to write this one as well as you wrote that one. My guitar's out of tune too, you want me to just leave it?
Just leave it. No, tune it up.
I think you're right, Mickey. Which way do I turn it if it's sharp, Red? South? Ragtag little girl, big blue eyes and yellow hair, barely standing 3 feet above the ground, dancing for a handout at the Crockett County Fair. She cast a spell on everyone around. Everybody called her Penny Annie. She danced for a penny, oh, for free. If Annie had been any older then, I bet a penny I'd have taken Annie home with me. Years went by and she became a legend at the fair, dancing for a penny, oh, for free. Then one year she didn't appear, no one knew just why. But now the Crockett County Fair ain't what it used to be. Then one night I saw her name on a flashing neon sign, saying Penny Annie dancing just for you. She was showing off her womanhood, doing the bump and grind, and I can't say that I enjoyed the view. She's still dancing, but not for a penny. She dances not for pleasure, but from pain. She's not the same Penny Annie anymore. She's dancing to try to feed the hunger in her veins. Now she works lying on her back, dancing to a different tune, doing 1 hour stands with any man she finds. She shoots away the pain, but then it comes again too soon. She's paying the fiddler who's been fiddling with her mind, her body, and mine. Didn't anybody ever tell you, Annie? If you dance, you pay the man who plays the tune. Dancing is fun, but when the dancing's done, sometimes you'll find you've danced with every devil in the room. Everybody called her Penny Annie. She danced for a penny, or for free. If Annie had been any older then, I bet a penny I'd taken Annie home with me. Dear God, I'm wishing I had taken Annie home. Something happier, hand me a razor blade. Mother ain't dead, she's just on vacation. That's what you call it.
Take a break, boys. What's that song? Oh, I don't want to cry this early this morning.
I know that one.
Have you learned it? Can they?
Yeah, they can honk in there with that. Y'all have I Don't Want to Cry? Get it up there, boys. Red, you play on this one, don't you? We play this in G, so Red can play with us. He only plays in G, A, and D. F. I'm living in F. I'm living in G. Put a capo on that thing, man. A one, two, three, four. Happy trails to you. Again. Happy trails. Take it, Roy.
I knew one of these days I'd meet you. Where's Trigger?
No, we stuffed
you're
him.
You're kidding me.
Stuffed horse.
Oh, no.
Chicken fried Shetland pony for six.
Oh, yes.
They're going to have to cut a lot of this shit. You know it? A one, two, three, and...
Sound easy, see, and it don't mean anything. You got to strain a little bit. Face got turned red, veins got to bulge out.
Well, let's take it up to A, and I'll show you how you. I don't want to cry.
There There you go.
The end. Finished. So, there's another one I lost a Grammy on.
That's still my favorite.
You like that?
Yeah.
Well, you told me a long time ago that the key to writing hit songs was to be simple. I don't mind be simple, to write simple.
Well, I'm
simple
just,
lyrics.
I'm there naturally. I don't have to work yet.
Oh, sure, you're there naturally. And here's a man that wrote a song that said, Saint Cecilia's in the garden picking paper violets. Her salvation is her virtue and her sins her emptiness. Now, that's simple.
Well, I try as hard as I can to be heavy, and I'm so just then, mediocre okay, enough to be successful.
He sang me this song one night. What a beautiful lyric about a lady who's taken the vow of chastity and married to Christ in the church. And this may not get on tape. This is some heavy shit. But anyway, she's standing out in the garden. Saint Cecilia's in the garden picking paper violets. Her salvation is her virtue and her sins her emptiness. I thought, that's one of the best verses I ever heard in my life. The next day he said, I changed it. I didn't like it. So he wrote, Saint Cecilia went a-sailing in a balsa wood canoe.
No. There was a whole nother verse.
Do you remember that song?
Saving the children, cried the captain to the crew.
To the crew.
We will leave this. No, I can't remember.
Well,
we will leave this.
What are you going to sing then?
You want to see my little
I want to see your new toy. Yes, I want to see your new toy. I want to see your new toy that you just gave me as a Christmas gift in September.
Jerry Kirk called it Martian Banjo.
Martian Banjo.
Lazy man's instrument. Now watch here. Now listen to this drummer.
Okay, I'm ready. Flip it on. Coffee. Don't everybody jump at once.
Voila!
And God said, let there be. Hitting band. That working man song. Y'all got working man songs?
Would you like a little note? Let me do that one more time. Working man sweats and slaves, works his way into his grave, slips away without a sound, slips into the cold, cold ground. But a mockingbird sing all day. Got no bills he's got to pay. Got no wife and he's got no home. Oh, he loved to ramble, loved to roam. Cut her
sweats and slaves, works his way into the grave, slips away into the cold, cold ground. Watch my fate.
You can go home, engineer.
We see that. I can't play in C. Now, how do you get back
serious,
on, Mickey?
Man. You're a sensitive writer.
Yes, that's true. Okay, now give me a...
You can just wrap it up now. He's hooked.
All the in a bank.
Last night when I showed it to you. And then you took it home, were you, and practiced
it? I took it to my room and put it on the bed, and I went to sleep in the other bed.
That's what you told me, but you lied, didn't you?
That's what you told me, but you lied. Ooh, let's start there.
Can't we take a break?
That's why she told me, but she lied.
Just a short one.
Pretty. Play that turn around again. That's, she called me lying. That pretty. Whine at that boy. Then she called on the train. Here he goes. Then I called her but it's over and undone. Makes you want to sing, but she's left me once and for all. Look out, fingers.
Songs that you
very first one. It's on the first album, the Pilgrim album. That one, The Heart, some more.
The Heart. Wasn't that, you wrote that later, didn't you?
It's in that first, it wasn't the first batch that I wrote, but it's in the first album. That and Penny Annie and Sweet Becky Walker, some of those things.
But did you ever hear about the little girl that came up to me at Floyd Kramer's golf tournament and thought I was you?
No.
She
can't. You're kidding.
She said, Larry, sign my. And I opened right to your picture, man, and signed, signed your name to it, and handed it to her, and thrilled her to death.
You were on a show, you were on a show like at Nashville Music or something, sitting down, just on the stool, had a guitar, had that nice soft lighting and all that. And Kristen, when she was about 2 and a half, my daughter, walked up to the TV and patted it and said, Daddy, Daddy. I thought, well, what the hell, I've been on the road a lot, it could be.
Gosh, Larry, how can I say?
Don't know how to tell me this. Well, she's going to college next year. You want to pay for
it?
This
is a heck of a time to break the news
on
to
national
you.
TV. That's a good way to know you're not going to get shot. So, well, I'm really the father of your children. I want to tell these multitudes of people.
No,
I know,
Larry,
you can't
the
shoot
truth
me.
Is, I'm your father. Son.
You're my father? You using the car Friday night? If you use the car, can I have this this new keyboard thing?
You got it. Can I have your plane?
That's not exactly an even trade.
It is, because I know how much you owe on the plane. I don't know anything on the machine.
Maybe my plane is your plane.
Oh, great. Larry, I'm going to Hawaii next week.
Hawaii?
Yeah.
You'll only get halfway. It won't go that far. Play me some songs. This has degenerated into some real trash. Were you planning on singing She Even Woke Me Up to Say Goodbye? Because if you don't, I'm going to.
Why don't you do it for me?
It's hard to argue logic.
You know all the words?
Morning's come.
Don't sing it with your nose closed. I don't sing like that no more.
Lord, my mind's aching. I would have written this song if I'd known the words. Sunshine, standing quietly at my door. Like the dawn, my heart is silently breaking.
Ain't that great? I love
it. And with my tears, come falling softly to the floor. Forgot the word. That's right, though. Once again, the whole town will be talking. I can see the pity that's in their eyes. Lord, they could never understand. It's her sorrow, it's not a man. And no matter what they say, God, I know she's tried. The baby's packed her soft things, and she's left me. And I know she didn't mean to make me cry. It's her heart, Lord. It's not her mind. She didn't mean to be unkind. Why she even woke me up to say goodbye. Good God, Mickey, what a song. It's her heart, Lord, it's not her mind. She didn't mean to be unkind. Why?
You don't know how much it pleases me to know you're going to put that out as your next single. I am just literally wouldn't thrilled to death. I don't know what to say, Larry. I'm so.
It wouldn't be a bad idea. Did we get that on tape? Boy, it's a beautiful song, Jim.
Woo!
Son. And all the words were in the dictionary if I just know what order they came in. Just think of that. Now you want to sing it with the right words? I was making those. Did I get them right?
You got them all right, but one.
She didn't mean to be unkind. Instead of she didn't mean to make me cry.
Not her heart. It's her mind.
It's not her heart, Lord. It's her mind. What did I say? I said it's not her heart, Lord.
No,
it's her
didn't mind.
I
said it's her heart. It's not her mind.
Oh, did I? Well, take it's not her heart, Lord, it's her mind. She didn't mean to be unkind.
Thank you.
Willie chords.
Yeah.
Well, what else do you know? I bet you don't know any of my songs.
Better they are.
I've already done it. I didn't know the words of that one. What else are you going to sing?
You want to hear Lovers?
Mm-hmm. Can I put this down so I can listen?
Red, y'all got Lovers?
I'm not going to talk about our girlfriends on stage on the TV, right?
Yeah,
we
go.
Oh. close. Come on, fingers, go.
We used to play this thing.
Once they were lovers, but now they're not friends. She loves another, he says it's the end. To think they once tore down a wall for a door. Now they don't speak anymore. So he walks the streets the few nights he can stand, drinking her memory away when he can. Friends once would reach out to him from the shore. Ah, but now they don't try anymore. How does it all come to happen? That's not what loving is for. And if I thought it was, I would leave here in the morning. I'd sooner sleep on. So when will we learn really what living is? Not what we get in return, but what we give. To think they once tore down a wall. They don't speak anymore.
And the heart is a funny thing with a mind all its own. It withers like a garden left untended and alone. And the thorns of loneliness invade and destroy what they can't steal so easy. And it feels just like being turned down by your one and only friend. So don't fool yourself by saying that it won't hurt. The pain ain't real, so easy to hurt. Ooh. so easy to hurt, but oh, so hard to heal.
Didn't Mathis cut that one time?
To death.
You know who would sing it? Great. That Spanish guy. What's his name?
Julio Iglesias?
Oh.
Julio?
Is he hot?
Boy, hot. The heart is a fun. He would. Boy, I'd make a big old lump jump up in my billfold, wouldn't it, if he'd sing that? I never thought about those two songs back to back, though, but they, I know who you wrote that about. They tore down a wall for.
That was, yeah, that
I know.
Happened, you know.
I mean, that over there at the executive house,
yeah.
Was it, where they live?
Murfreesboro. Everybody thought it was real metaphoric. He actually cut a hole in the wall.
I know it. Yeah, these two people we know. Yeah. They live next door to each other in these apartments, and they said, what the hell? I'm tired of going outside to get over there.
No, Hank did. She was at work. She was Fred's secretary, as a matter of fact.
So Hank...
So he got a
chainsaw
and she comes home and there's
a wall, I wrote a line.
They tore down a wall for a door and people came. Oh, what a heavy line! And I'd tell them what actually happened and they'd just be crushed. You know? I mean, all of a sudden it took all of the beauty out of the line.
Well, they ought to realize that a lot of people wouldn't have seen it in the first place, right? They just said, well, Hank got drunk again.
Door, you did.
Yeah. The guy whose power supply went down when Hank plugged in the electric saw. Got muffler fumes in the kitchen.
Oh, man, I would like to write a book about Hank and some of his exploits. He and Willie's deal down in the Bahamas.
Oh, Lord. The good Hank. The third night I was in Nashville, I went to a session that Jack did out at Bradley's barn before it burned down. And he said, son, one thing you have to remember, don't say anything clever around me. I have a very creative memory.
I'd get a little line, and I'd have it laying there. Hank and Red and Glenn Martin, a bunch of them be sitting around, and I'd just drop it in conversation and just watch. Boy, and you can see every eye twitch. You know, and Hank was the first one to go to the door, man. He'd just slip out, man.
I've got to go TT.
He'd have it written by the time...
He always says one line in the song that just tore my head up that I hated, you know, like, wouldn't be smart on my part and don't touch me. Mm-hmm. And I said, Hank, I said, you've always got one line in every song that just gnaws on me, you know. And a little bit of tear let me down and it's rhymed a door with something, I don't know, something. He said, you put something bad in there and he said, they remember it.
That's what wouldn't be smart on my part. You know, he was asleep one night. He and Red were trying to write a song. And Hank went to sleep. Stone cold sleep. And Red came over to him and said, woke him up and said, I need one line that rhymes with, I've placed my love in your hands. And he said, if I'd known how you were going to treat it, I wouldn't have, not done it when I placed it. He said, it has to rhyme with placed it. And Hank woke up and said, you made your mark and then erased it. And went right back to sleep and it just fell in perfectly. You know, if I'd have known better before I placed it, you made your mark and then erased it. He went right back off to sleep. Never, you know.
Oh.
That's the way the boy
is. Hank does demos and he'll just sing. You know, Hank can sing. And he'd sing, he'd sit around and if he wasn't drunk, he'd act drunk. And he'd sing them terrible. And I said, Hank, I know you can sing. He said, yeah, but he said, if I sing... He said, then they ain't going to want to cut
them. That's right. So they think they do better than me. It's a challenge.
Anybody can do better than me. Yeah.
Perfect. Did y'all get any of that? That was some heavy horse shit.
Oh, yeah.
Boy, you really knocked me out.
Boy, accidentally, I walked. You know, we knew how these stages used to be about that high. And they were separated. I walked between the two of them.
Hello.
Both hit me right under both arms.
Jeez. Yeah.
Da-ba-da-da-da.
Charlie McCoy cut an album, cut a deal, and he went in with about 15 harmonic overdubs.
Yeah, right.
Huh? Went in with about 15 harmonic overdubs, and he came in, and he was thrilled dead, and he said, listen to this. He did, what was that thing about the Tallahatchie Bridge? With 15, I mean, he had harmonicas this big and this little, you know, and he gets through, and he comes in, and he's thrilled, and he said, listen to this. And it sounded exactly like a...
When I get in the car.
I listened to it, and I was trying to be knocked out. And I said, that's good. And I said, who's playing it? I said, that's really interesting. I'm
Dick and Tito?
Yeah.
Just as easy to get an accordion.
I know he puts them harps on him. Yeah. His face is so funny. I've seen him in sets. You can't even see his face sometimes.
Yeah. He's a very fast harmonica player or a very slow accordion player.
Yeah.
Rolling.
Now that we've heard all the old songs, you got anything new? I mean, I've heard you're only as hot as your last 3 minutes.
Is that hot?
That's hot. Does it go with
the thing? In a blues day, Weeble is gone away. Black has turned to gray. In a blues day, ain't no jazz today. Not on Bourbon Street, L.A. What would Satchmo say?
What would Satchmo say?
Man, there ain't no jazz today. But wasn't Lefty right?
Wasn't Lefty right? Did you
when
say
he
that?
Turned on his eye? Yes, he was out of sight. Oh, wasn't Lefty right? So long, Frizzell. I knew you so well, and I know it was hell. So long, Frizzell. Lord, I love the country song that brightens up my day. If he could see the way it's gone, I just know old Hank would say, ain't no news today. Ain't nothing new to say. But everything's okay. The music's here to stay.
Very strange person, Mickey. You're a very, very strange
person.
Yeah,
he's from country with your teeth together. Wow. That's right. Why do you, Ernie Stubb got, he sang, he sang the drunk so long that that's how he got his style. I'm a walking up Lord. Oh. And there evolves a style. Simple.
Strange person. I'd like to take a tape recorder or a piece of paper and just walk around in your brain for a couple of hours. Just to see if there's anybody home. we've been around musicians and people, and they understand that the way you think. You know, I've said that you taught me how, if you can teach somebody how to write songs, I guess there's some kind of ability there, but you taught me how to write story songs or how to write a story in a song. From Willie, I learned how to write.
I had not planned.
Well, if you said one thing about Willie that characterized his songs, to me he's the best first line songwriter in the world. I mean, how can you help but listen to, well, hello there. I mean, you got to listen to the rest of that, right? Or crazy. I mean, you got to listen to the rest of it, right? See? Or Chris taught me how maybe to use the language a little bit, use it, twist it. Yeah. You want another cigarette? Hey, Larry. But, and Roger, you know, taught us all maybe how to look at the world a little bit
crazy.
Like this. Crazy. But you, I mean, that's, wasn't Lefty right? I mean, give me a break.
Wasn't it?
Yeah, Lefty was right. I don't know what to follow that with except an off-the-wall song. Is that all right?
You betcha.
Because this, you haven't heard this one, is kind of.
Didn't give me a chance to.
It wasn't your turn. As close as I'll get. I think it's just rattling. It's probably in tune. I live in the window of Willoughby's menswear. Lord knows it ain't wearing too well. 'Cause old Willoughby undresses me in front of all them strangers in my 4x6 plate glass hell. I'm in love with a wool mannequin in a window across the street. She's the prettiest thing I've ever seen. I'm just a mannequin, but man, I can dream. I'm a mannequin in the window of Willoughby's menswear. Lord knows it's a pain in the glass.
Yes.
If I could just one time catch a Willoughby bent over. Well, hell, Mick, just fill in the blanks. 'Cause I'm in love with a wool mannequin in a window across the street. She's the prettiest thing I've ever seen. I'm just a mannequin, man, I can dream. Man, I can dream about crossing the street. Man, I can dream about holding my wool mannequin in my arms. We could make love at 2 o'clock in the morning. 'Cause what the normal folks don't know can't do the normal folks no harm. I'm in love with a wool mannequin in a window across the street. She's the prettiest thing I've ever seen. I'm just a mannequin, man, I can dream. I'm just a mannequin, but man, I can dream.
Roger would love that.
He liked that.
You hear that song called Friends?
Ooh, old friends. friend.
We were sitting up in the hotel room here a while back, you know, and I said, he started singing that song. He got to the end. I said, "Old friend, what did we discover at the Rainbow's End other than no reason to go back again, old friend?"
Whoa!
He said, You did it again, you little poot.
Oh, we can't say poot on TV. Have Putin. Poot, have Putin.
Hmm? You can in Texas, but you can in Canada.
That's right. Words don't mean the same in Texas that they mean
anywhere.
In England. Anyway. There with that story.
Well,
I'm stuck.
Play me something else.
What do you want to hear? Well, you know Dottie, how much I love Dottie. And she taught me. I got on a binge one out on her bus.
Pain in the glass?
Huh?
Pain in the glass? You didn't do it.
I said, yeah.
Real cute.
I know, you told me don't ever be cute, be clever. But that's all I could think of at that point in time. My mind's gone to Memphis, where I know she'll be sleeping, laying softly alone. My thoughts of her keeping me going, with no reason to keep holding on. I'm holding on. My mind's gone to Memphis, going, gone. Who needs a mind anyway, with nothing to think on, except that she's gone away and left me all alone to face the breaking of the day, with a mind that is shattered and gone from this hollow piece of clay. My mind's gone. Where I know she'll be sleeping, laying softly alone. My thoughts of her keeping me going, with no reason to keep holding on. I'm holding on. My mind's gone to Memphis, going, gone. Bus one night going through Memphis. Dottie
Didn't
said, "Why don't you write a song about Memphis?" Yeah, she cut it. Great, it's a great cut.
Oh, that album you cut on her, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No, it was on the old. That's a 10-year-old album. One of the first things she did, she cut on that session. But the last album she did, "Bitter They Are" and "Try to Win a Friend," and another song I wrote for her called "Dream" that got a little out of hand. But she's the first one to ever introduce me to your music. That old "It Looks Like Rain" album. Tick tock, tick a what's that song? Black Cat backing up a
Big oak tree.
And me, I'm just
looking.
What's the name of that song?
Teetotal Tommy.
Teetotal Tommy took a toke of tea. I mean, what he did was he drank some tea. Or
real
something.
Real cute, wasn't it?
Clever. Wasn't cute. You don't write cute, you write clever. What do we do now? I'm stuck in the middle of a fucking pause.
Okay.
I'm riding the crest of a slump.
Well, let's see. Let's have a plug here and figure out where we are.
Ah.
I I've gone to sleep.
Boy, I'm not kidding you. My creative juices have dried up. That's what you get for drinking two beers and eating a bowl of soup.
Ian, help. What do you want? Send the dancing girls out here.
Everybody on stage for the Hawaiian number.
You want to try apples dipped in candy? We can try it and see how it works.
What are we going to close with? What do we finish with? The two trilogies? Yeah, what do you do after those?
You do.
What's on the list that we haven't done?
Ball games. You spend the rest of your career doing ball games and Bob Hope specials.
The only thing I've got left, that's right, is songwriter's trilogy.
We want to do that? Do you want to do that? It sure is long and drug out.
What? How many times must a piper be paid?
Yeah, it's
well,
so
who
long
gives a shit?
Out.
I want to hear the son of a bitch. You can sing that whole album. I turned back the covers on a bed where two lovers found a reason to start.
Did you hear Rogers cut on it? You could have a pretty fair record on it.
In a room filled with memories, a house built for love. On the street.
Only in a song can you have Swiss Cottage Place, which is in London.
Cottage Place.
Got to by a bus. You know that?
Really?
Yeah.
My mind surrenders as all the remembers come and steal the moment away. Cute. That ain't cute. Fucking cute. All the remembers instead of the memories. Yeah. And I've worked Cleveland. Well, you gonna do how many times, Mr. Piper? Well, all I've got left to sing is
apples dipping candy sweet.
All I've got left is my trilogy.
Steam. Running out of steam. Sweet memories. We got sweet memories we can do.
What can you do sweet memories in?
God darn guitar.
Sweet, sweet. Hey, we gotta do that together. You do. I'll just do the bridge with you if you want to.
We all look awake, don't we?
Well, I'm telling you, nothing like a good meal to put your career right in a dumper. Sweet memories. What is the lineup you got there? Sweet memories. Dropped in.
Yeah, I don't know.
Songwriter trilogy.
I don't know if I can do that thing or not. Ian. Just dropped in. Okay.
Memories dropped in. Ugh. Songwriters, American trilogy. And we're through. It's magic. Well, kick the sumbitch off. When I nod my head, hit it. Waiting on me, you backing up. Oh. she slipped.
If I drop my, if I quit playing it, you know, into the sun, happening wonder. I might just start playing them.
Of my dreams last.
You can't play a tempo.
Wandering from room to room, she's turning on each light. Laughter spilled like water from the river to the sea, and I'm swept away from sadness, clinging to, it's the wrong chord, Larry, her memory. The feet. Sweet. I haven't sung a duet. I want to sing a duet with you. I haven't sung a duet with you on a record since that time that Bobby Bear was producing that thing on you.
Yeah.
Sing Sweet Leave Memories for me. Sing Sweet Memories for me, and I'll sing harmony on the beat. I never get to sing harmony. Steve Rudy always sing harmony.
I feel so real sorry for you, Larry. That's why it's called Larry Gatlin Band, not the Steve Rudy Band.
That's one way to look at it. I knew you'd look at it that way.
My world is like a river, as dark as it is deep. Night after night, the past slips in and gathers all my sleep. My day. Just an endless dream of emptiness to me, filled only by the fleeting moments of her memory. Sweet.
At you voted for Nixon.
I voted for Nixon.
You
I
would.
Lost, I lose all the time.
Golly. Son, I can see Adolf Hitler sitting on the steps of the Reichstag with a tear in his eye.
Really? Are you that old? Larry, let's wrap it up.
Dead time. You remember the first time you, first time I ever saw you, Red got his boat, and we went out across Old Hickory. That's where you were parked in your houseboat. The very first time, it was about 3 o'clock in the morning, you were asleep, so we waited for the sun to come up and waited to wake you up.
The first time was when Dottie brought you out to the house.
Well, Dottie was in the boat that night, the very first time I ever saw you. And I was nervous, because they told me, you know, this guy said, you know, you look like, y'all look alike, y'all act alike, you're both ornery. And the first time I ever heard the trilogy, you hadn't even put it out on a record yet. You just put that thing all together.
Is that right?
Yep. First time I ever heard it.
It just seemed like it's been that long ago. I guess it has been.
It was 1971.
That's the first year Susan and I got married. So.
Yeah. 1971. Right? What, it came out in 72, didn't it? 72? Early 73? And other than that, I'm just lost and don't have a damn thing to say.
Sing that song for me.
Which one?
Songwriter's Trilogy.
My trilogy? Well, I got it.
Are we ready to sing Songwriter's Trilogy? Excuse me. I'm jumping the gun.
I just got lost and forgot where we were. Well, I got my idea. You know, you wrote the American Trilogy. A good friend of mine and yours, Steve Fromholz, wrote a great song called the Texas Trilogy.
Gordon Lightfoot wrote the
Canadian Trilogy, right. Trilogy. And
Railroad Trilogy, Red played on that.
Yeah, you wrote that record.
Best album.
Well, I wrote this song.
Milestone album.
I was writing 3 different songs, and I couldn't get any one of them finished. I finally realized they were all the same song, just extensions of it. So I wrote part of it about being in Nashville singing in the, you know, at happy hour where nobody wants to, you know. Everybody's been to happy hour. Right? I mean, I don't mean as the happy hour or, I mean the happy hour evening. The guy who's sitting there trying to make music for the drunks before they have to go home and face mama. And they'd sit there and they wouldn't listen to music, and it got me all bent out of shape. So I wrote this song. The light shines on me every night from 9 to 1:30. And the customers own me, 'cause I sing what they want to hear and not what I feel. And it makes me feel dirty. It's not a matter of not being able to score. It's just a simple matter. It don't matter anymore. And when it's over, I just take it on home alone. Six-year-old whiskey for the pain. Two-day-old newspaper umbrella for the rain. 30 years of figuring out what to be if I get grown. And when it's over, I just take it on home alone. Ooh. That's the first songwriter I was, and it got progressively a little bit better. Got a dime's worth of nickels in this guitar case I'm carrying. Got a nickel's worth of pennies in my jeans. Got inside full of craving for some coffee and a sweet roll. But my lack of bankroll just rolled in between. Got at least 1,000,000 miles on these boots and jeans I'm wearing. My grip slickers wore out from the rain. Hell, I don't know where I'm going, so there ain't no need in hurrying. God knows the road's the marketplace for pain. Won't somebody you get me off this dead-end highway, singing my old homemade songs over and over again. 'Cause they don't want to hear my homemade songs, they want to hear I did it my way. It's a great song, but I ain't gonna sing I did it my way, Mr. Anka. Instead, I'll just do it my way. God knows the road's the marketplace for pain. Dear God, I'm sitting here wondering just how lucky can one man be? They've paid good money to hear these borrowed songs, songs you've kindly loaned to me. Dear God, I'm sure I'm grateful in every way I can. And every time I hold that pencil, Lord, would you kindly hold my hand? 'Cause writing songs and singing songs, God, that's why I'm here. Sometimes bring a smile, sometimes a laugh, sometimes a tear. And I'll try to show I'm grateful, Lord, in every way I can. And every time I hold that pencil, Lord, would you kindly hold my hand? And every time I hold this guitar, Lord, would you kindly hold my help me do it half as good as Mickey does, and I'll be satisfied.
That's real corny.
But I mean it. You know I do. You know I mean it. I'll whip your ass if you think I don't.
I know you
little asshole. Humility doesn't sit well with your ass, Newbury. Don't even try it. Don't pull this humble routine on me.
On
this is Larry you're talking about, talking to.
Beat you on the golf course now.
10 years, and he finally beat me twice out of 8,000.
Ed, can we take a small set to just for a second? All right, Mikey. That's mighty good. I'm about wore out.
I am too. We didn't do anything. We ain't done anything. I'll tell you what, I shouldn't have eaten dinner. I got lost. I got lost.
Right.
Test, 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 test.
Well,
sounds different, doesn't it? It sounds like an old one. I told him, I said, I want that old flat, that old sound, that old Cherokee Cowboys. Jimmy, boy, when he was right, God, when he was right, Emmett said he's the best he ever heard when he was right. I saw him play in the garden one night, you know, the gospel song, I Come to the Garden Alone. He was playing it on a Willie Nelson album. Willie, he did one album for Atlantic. He did the Phases and Stages album, and we did a gospel album. And Dave played on it, and I saw him crying on the back of his hands.
Hey, Larry, and it was just, sure
it was just
sure
unbelievable.
Have you heard that? That was the way it was then. That was the way it was then.
Put it on. Say goodbye.
The hobo still answer the highwayman's call. Oh no, thank you, babe.
You got to put your RM.
Yeah, I've got to put that thing back in my pocket.
This has been fun, Mickey. I
couldn't. Norman, I think we're ready to be at the post, sir.
All right.
It's amazing how much it takes out of you, though. This is the kind of thing I've dreamed about us doing for years. Just sitting I'm drained. I'm emotionally drained. It's like I'd rather go do three concerts as far as the emotional part of what I've done today.
That's fine until we took a break. Then I got warm.
And I think the enormity of the whole thing hit when I said, you know, this is something I've dreamed about doing with my hero. One of my heroes. One of my heroes. And you know that.
First thing I'm going to do is get this guitar worked on.
Yeah,
I had a guy work on it, it's all either that or the next.
Yeah, what a tinsmith is not like
a guitar. What you get it for taking to a millwright, man.
That's right. you
take it to
Leon
Rhodes.
Fixer?
Like Roy Clark said, I'd like to see the guy's belly who invented an Ovation guitar. So does it go this way, or does it just kind of fit in there like?
It's always sliding. I've got Glenn's first one, you know, and it's a
lot bigger. Yeah,
it's slick. It don't have this roughed up on the back. It slides right off of you.
Oh, remember they came with that little rubber piece that you can slide it, put it on that on the.
Well, they got a new one now that's about half as. It's about like that.
I played about like as well as it.
Well, let's just get right into it.
What are you going to do?
Trilogy.
I've heard of it.
Yes. I really did borrow some songs.
We've been rolling for 10 minutes. Are you ready to do it?
I'm ready. You ready?
Oh, I wish I was in the land of cotton. Old times there are not forgotten.
We're not rolling. Sorry, babe. And you had your feel going, baby.
That's all right, bud.
Oh, I got a song. Wait, before you do that, though, I got this important. Very few people have done it would like this. Chestnuts roasting
on an open flame.
No, chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Stab licking at his nose. Yule's jambalaya being sung by a choir and folks. What keys? Okay. A jambalaya being sung by a choir and folks dressed up like Wesley Rose. Eddie Arnold knows exactly where his record goes from 91 to 92. And though she's been had many times, many ways, Mary Davis to you.
Let's just go ahead and get about 10 lawsuits.
And that. Folks dressed up like Wesley Rose.
I love that.
Oh, I dare you to do it on the award show one time.
Oh, shit. It'd be the last one I'd do. Mary,
hey, you ought to get him to do that and then just bleep the whole thing out.
Just yes, bleep, bleep,
bleep, bleep, bleep, da, 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 bleep.
Fire.
Oh, did you really?
We just taped it. Shit.
Now you're in for it, kid.
Real trouble.
Hey, don't bleep it out and we'll all go to the lawsuit.
Hey, Buddy Killen and Billy Sherrill wrote the song. I just
finished,
put the last line in there. Billy and
oh, don't try to blame it on Billy now.
Billy claims everything. We might as well give him this one.
Well, he got mad at you because you didn't play it for him before y'all wrote it.
One more for Fingers Newbury.
Oh, I wish I was in the land of cotton. Old times there are not forgotten. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Oh, I wish I was in Dixie, way, way, in Dixieland I'll take my stand, to live and die in Dixie, Dixieland. That's where I was born. Early on one frosty morning, look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Hush, little baby, don't you cry.
bound to die.
Oh, it sounds like a toilet flushing. One more time. All right. Man,
what can you say?
Say something.
I took a real good opportunity to shut up after that.
Rap. Good night. See you next year, maybe. If you get hot this time.
What's your last album? What's the last album you did? I don't know if I have the last two or three. His Eyes on the
Last
Sparrow.
Was out.
Yeah, Eyes on the Sparrow. What was it?
3,000 copies of The Sailor. You know the one I play for your girls?
Which one?
The Sailor.
The Sailor. The Sailor's the last one out?
Yeah. But I bought it back, and so it's not out. It's now.
Was it on Electra?
No, it was on Polygram.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah,
right. Eyes on the Sparrow's on Electra, isn't it?
No, ABC.
Is it? Good Lord, there's three or four of them I don't have.
Well, they're all gone. They all got lost, you know. Even the Electra albums.
Oh, yeah, they're...
No, MCA bought, you know, ABC went bankrupt, and they all got lost on the way to the...
They got lost. What do you mean they got lost?
They got masters got lost.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, all of them. Every one of them.
Frisco Mableton, that's all they lost.
Yeah, see, I bought all of them from Electra when I went to ABC, and then ABC went bankrupt. Even the Mercury album. Is that it, boy? Yeah, it's all lost. All my masters. How can I do that?
What?
You think so, huh? I didn't think about it. It's their property.
I don't know, but they don't have property of your voice and your likeness and your image. It's just like a book. Publisher loses some of that manuscript to a book.
I pulled that tape off and thought half of my part of my shirt went with it. Bro,
see, when I was on Berkeley, when I left Berkeley, I bought the album from Electra. Then when I left Electra, I bought the album and sold to ABC.